Dear students, let me continue the fourth module. In this module, the next chapter which we are going to study is overview of IPC method, means overview of inter-process communication method. In this chapter, the first topic which we are going to study is the pipes. So only one topic I have selected in this video, because for the 10 minutes video, this one topic is enough, because this is a little lengthy topic. So let us see what is inter-process communication. When two processes communicate with each other or share some common data with each other without interfering, then that is called inter-process communication. So inter-process communication enables one application to control another application and for several applications to share the same data without interfering with one another. Here, the several applications will share the same common resources or same data without interfering with communicating with each other is called inter-process communication. The different forms of IPC or inter-process communication are half duplex pipes, FIFO, full duplex pipes, named full duplex pipe, it is also called streams pipe, message queues, shared memory, semaphores, socket and streams. So let us study the first method of IPC, that is called pipes. What is pipe? So pipes are the oldest form of unique system inter-process communication. So pipes are basically, it is a way, it is a thing which makes two processes communicate with each other. So pipes are something kind of buffer which can hold some data so that one process can read the data from the pipe and another process can write the data into the pipe. So the pipes have two limitations. One limitation, it is a half duplex, means data flow can take place only one direction, either from A to B or from B to A. If two processes A and B are communicating, so data can be flown only from A to B or from B to A. So that is the one way communication can be established using the pipes. Second disadvantage is pipes can be used only between processes that have a common ancestor. Means the if two processes are created from the same ancestor, only those processes can communicate with each other. For example, the parent process and child process can communicate, because parent process and common and child process have the same ancestor. So normally a pipe is created by a process. A process can create a pipe, then process will call a fork function and it will create a child process, and the inter-process communication can happen using the pipe between parent process and the child process. Now for example, how to create a pipe? Pipe we can create, a pipe is created by calling the pipe function. For example, integer pipe, integer file descriptor 2, and which is present in the hash include unistd.h. So this function, it returns 0 if OK and minus 1 on error. Two file descriptors are returned through the file descriptors. Here, on successful creation of pipe, two file descriptors, that is FD0 and FD1, will be returned. So this function, it will return two file descriptors. One is FD0 and another is FD1. So FD0 is used for writing, FD0 is used for reading the data from the pipe, and FD1 is used to write the data into the pipe. Now, for example, let us see here, two pictures are there. A process has created a pipe. Now, a pipe, it will return two file descriptor, FD0 and FD1. So, if the process wants to read the data, then it will use FD0, and if the process wants to write the data into the pipe, it will use FD1 file descriptor. Now, this thing is happening in only one single process, so that is not so much useful, because IPC is used to establish the communication between two processes. But here only one process is there. Now here, one more thing is there, user process, a pipe is created, a pipe, it will return two things, FD0 and FD1. So process wants to write the data into the pipe, so it will use FD1, file descriptor 1. Using FD1, it will write the data into the pipe, and using FD0, it will read the data from the pipe. And this pipe will be present in the kernel. Next, suppose how the inter-process communication can happen using the pipe between parent process and the child process. So here, first parent process, it will create the pipe. Once the pipe will be created, then it will return two things, FD0 and FD1. Then parent process will call a fork function, and it will create a child process. So child process is also created. Now parent process want to write the data to the child process. Then what parent process has to write the data into pipe, and child process will read the data from the pipe. So with which file descriptor parent process will write the data into the pipe? Using FD1. So FD0 will be closed. So in the parent process, FD0 will be closed, and using the FD1, a parent process will write the data into the pipe. And since child process has to read only the data, then which file descriptor it will read the data? It will read the data from the FD0. So here FD1 will be closed, and FD0 will be invoked, and data of the pipe will be read from the FD0. So in the parent process overall, FD0 will be closed, and child process FD1 will be closed. So in parent process, FD1 will write the data into the pipe, and in child process, FD0 will read the data from the pipe. Now once the parent process will close the FD0 and child process will close the FD1, then parent process will write the data into the pipe using FD1. And child process will read the data from the pipe using FD0. So this is the diagram. Similarly, if the child process want to write the data into the pipe and parent process will read the data, then child process will close the FD0, and using FD1, it will write the data into the pipe. And parent process will close the FD1, and using FD0 file descriptor, it will read the data from the pipe. Next, for a pipe, from the child to the parent, parent close FD1. All these things which I discussed, it is written here. Let us study the same situation using one program. So, I am writing the program for the inter-process communication using the pipe. So, here we have defined some variable integer n, integer FD2, two file descriptor array. Then PID underscore T PID. So char line max line. So if here we are creating a child process, if PID, we are creating a pipe. If PID FD less than 0, error system, pipe error. Otherwise, if the pipe is created here, it will return two file descriptors.